Hi! Welcome back. In honor of Earth Day being like a week ago, I wanted to do a video on my zero waste tips and tricks and what I use. I'm not zero waste like at all, but I am trying very hard. It's definitely like a process. Like you can't just like, I mean, you totally could just do it overnight, but it would be really hard to do that. Working towards getting there, but every effort is a good effort. What I use to attempt to be zero waste. Let's stop. Okay, first thing, I have my water bottle. I feel like this is just like so obvious, but people are still buying plastic water bottles for some reason. Like, I take this with me literally every place that I go. Even like around my house, like I always am like just carrying it around my house wherever I go. But yeah, a reusable water bottle. You can get one at the store for like $5. You can get one at the thrift store for like $1. It doesn't have to be like the most fancy water bottle in the world. Like I got this on Amazon for like $10, I think. And I've had it for almost a year now. Next, I have my babies. These are all of my, most of my reusable shopping bags. I have like way too many. Like I went to the grocery store on Earth Day and my grocery store was handing out free reusable bags for Earth Day. And the guy at the register was like, do you want one? And I like thought about it for a second. I was like, no, like I really don't need any more. So I have this one. I got this at H&M like 2 years ago. I've had this, not even two, maybe like three or four. I got this at H&M a while ago and it's still going so strong. Like this is a very large, high quality bag. Like whenever I go to the grocery store, I take this one and then this other blue one that I got at H&M and it holds everything I get for the week, just these two bags, which I think is very nice. So then it like it's so easy to bring in my groceries whenever I do grocery shop. And then in there, I also have my little like cloth produce bags. I got these ones because you can put produce in them. Like usually if I'm getting like bulk mushrooms, I put them in these, but you can also use them in the bulk area at the store. Because they're like basically the same weight as like the plastic bulk bags, so it doesn't add any extra weight and it's honestly just the easiest thing I've found to use. Like I know a lot of people bring jars and stuff, but this is just so convenient and like really easy to just like throw in your bag. It's a lot easier than carrying around glass jars, so I love these a lot. The other day I finally got something I've been wanting for a while, just because I think they're so cute. I got bamboo straws. I have metal straws already and I've had them for a while, but honestly, they're just getting kind of gross. And every time like I use them, I kind of like smell them and they don't smell too good because I use them like every day. I'm making a goal with myself to keep these clean. We'll see if I can do it, but I think they're so cute and like look how thick that straw is. I just love how thick they are, and then they like come in like different sizes. So like see how thick this one is versus how thin this one is. I love them so much, and it came with a cleaner, so I'm gonna make sure to clean them. But just like having a reusable straw in your bag all the time, just take it with you wherever you go with your water bottle, with your reusable shopping bags. Like as long as you have this stuff with you, there's no excuse to get a straw or something like that. You get to see my very gross bamboo toothbrush or wooden toothbrush, I don't even know. But I've had this for a while and I was gonna say, I've been thinking about this a lot. Do you think you have to get a new toothbrush like every so often, or can you just wash the one you have? Like, is that weird? I've been thinking about it a lot. I don't know if it's weird or not, so let me know if that's weird. I feel like that's not, like you should totally just be able to wash it. Why would you have to get a new one? I don't know. It makes sense to me. But it is like, it's like dark black because I use a charcoal toothpaste, so that's why it's that color. Okay, next. So the next thing I have, I won't actually show you them because that might be kind of gross, but in here I have my two menstrual cups. And here I have these like reusable panty liners in here that I use whenever I get my period. I got these because for a while I was like using my menstrual cup, but then like at night or something I would like put on a pad just because I wanted to be extra protective on the days when my period does get really heavy. I was still using a pad and like having to throw that away every day. So it was just kind of like not, like it was like it felt weird, like it felt stupid. So I finally got these on Amazon. They were actually pretty cheap. And like, I do want to say like, I didn't buy all of this stuff at once because I know it does get pretty pricey to have to do that. But if you slowly just like start building up, like maybe 1 month you buy something, the next month you buy something else that you want to like swap out. Like there's such easy swaps you can make. And you definitely don't have to do it all at once. Like do it as you can. That's what I did. And then like with this, like it was me either buying pads every month or buying this once and then never have to buy, like I never have to buy any sort of period product ever again. And that feels so good. I love a freaking bargain. So I've got these two things and they work like goddamn champs. I love them so much. I'm just like very happy about these two products and I highly recommend them. One of the last things I have is these. So I've had these for a while. These are Norwex cloths. I actually got some new ones over Christmas because these were like 6 years old. I've had these for so long. They're basically just what I use to wash my face. They have, I don't know the science behind them exactly, but they have some sort of thing stitched into them to where they don't get super gross after you use them. So they're really good to use on like your face and like your body and like even like in your kitchen, like they have stuff for the home too, are really good with like you know, like you use a rag and like the next day it smells terrible. These don't do that. So there's my science behind these. Yeah, they just like don't get super gross after a while. You switch it out like every 3 days with a new one and then wash it and then it's like back to normal. So I love using these on my face because they just make me feel extra clean. And then after I wash my face with those, this is my most recent purchase. I got some of these like reusable makeup wipes. They're just like little cotton wipes. There's really not much to them. But basically I put, after I wash my face, I put moisturizer on these and then I just rub it all over my face so I don't have to use my fingers. Cause I am really weird about that. I don't like touching my face. I think it's so gross. Yeah, so, and my moisturizer is just aloe vera. I just like pour aloe vera on these and then I just like wipe my face with it. So yeah, that's the extent of my skincare. I don't wear makeup, I don't do any of that, so I don't really have to worry about that, which is honestly nice. I love the fact that I don't have to worry about that. Basically all the products I have, I also have way too many mason jars, like way more than anybody would need. But I do have a tip on that. Whenever you are trying to get any kind of like Tupperware or mason jar, anything for like your kitchen, go to a thrift store. The thrift stores have so many jars, so many Tupperwares. They have so many kitchen supplies. I just bought a new pot, pan, and silverware. And I got it all at the thrift store and I spent maybe like 10 bucks, I think. And it wasn't new, it was used, so like you're not creating that more demand for more things because these thrift stores do have so much stuff. So if you do need anything new like that, go to the thrift store first and see if they have it there. Even like a cupcake pan. Like if you want to make some cupcakes, go to the thrift store and look for a cupcake pan. If you want to make cake, they definitely have cake pans. The last time I went, I saw like 7 cake pans and they even have like sets and stuff. And I like looked at it, I was like, I mean, it's only $1, like, do I need a cake pan? Like, I'll probably make a cake once and then never use it again. I didn't get it, but if I ever wanted to make a cake, I know I can, for cheap. So, the home section and, like, kitchen section of thrift stores is probably one of my favorite parts. I love it so much. And on that note, if you need clothes, another thing you can do to really help the environment is thrift shopping, buying secondhand, getting hand-me-downs. Anything helps, because I've recently, not that I didn't know this before, that the fashion industry is one of the top polluters on, like, in the world, but I've kind of recently realized the extent of it. Like, it's pretty bad. Thinking, I kind of do this thing where, like, fun thing where sometimes I fall into, like, a downward spiral about the planet and how how bad it is, and how big corporations are just ruining everything. But it makes sense, because people are creating a demand for these things, so these corporations are going to continue to make their products, you know? But man, the fashion industry, thinking about how often people go shopping, how many stores are stocked with clothes that are just gonna end up in a landfill, that shit hurts my soul. For me, that's how it was about, like, single-use containers and stuff. Like, whenever you go to, like, a restaurant or something and you get something to go. I used to work at Panera, and I worked in the drive-thru of Panera. So every day I would package up the soups, package up the sandwiches, and send them through. And every day we would have hundreds and hundreds of people come through the drive-thru and get these to-go cups, to-go straws, all of this stuff, all this plastic stuff. And every single day of me working there, it got to the point where I would just fall into downward spirals thinking about the amount of trash we are creating as a single store. And then I would think about every Panera in the world. And then I would think about every fast food place in the world. And I would just, like, lose my mind thinking about that. So, because, like, you see it firsthand, you see people just, like, mindlessly creating so much trash. At least do what you can to help, you know? So yeah, downward spirals are fun. That's the conclusion of that. And obviously I'm not zero waste, I'm not perfect. I do not own a trash can though, and I think that's pretty good. I only have a recycling bin and a compost bin. That's all I got, that's all I need. Which I'm pretty proud of that. And I do have some goals for this upcoming month that I've made for myself, because I am slowly transitioning and not trying, like, I can't do it all at once, but I can do it slowly. So my goals for these next, for this next month is to, I don't want to use any more to-go containers from, like, takeout places, because I do love getting takeout from my favorite Asian restaurant often. Calling in and asking them to, like, make it on a plate, and then I come in and I just, like, put it in my to-go containers. I'm gonna try to do that. And also whenever I'm at work, I do take food home sometimes. I've been really good about it lately though, because I always have, like, jars with me from, like, drinking, like, a juice at work. So then I just empty out the jar and then put my to-go food into that jar, because usually it's, like, just, like, veggies or something. But sometimes I don't have anything to put it in, so I'm gonna get better about doing that. That's one of my goals. And then another one of my goals is to have zero waste, like, hair care products. So I'm gonna look for a good zero waste shampoo bar and conditioner bar. So if you have any recommendations for that, let me know, because I wanna buy them. Let me know what your zero waste goals are for this next month, this next year. Where are you at? I wanna know. Let's talk. Thank you guys for watching this video. Yeah, okay, cool. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!